A woman treated at a New York hospital could possibly be the first female to have been cured of HIV. According to research presented at a World Medical Conference Tuesday, this is the third person cured of the virus that causes AIDS. News 19's Archie Snowden explains what the medical breakthrough could mean for others living with HIV.
And doctors say the case of this woman, known only as New York patient, is one step closer to a cure. But, and there's a huge word of caution here, the cutting-edge treatment used is only a strategy for the millions of people living with HIV. Dr. Michael Sag, an infectious disease expert at UAB Hospital, says it's important for people to know the details about the treatment of the woman with HIV, who researchers say appears to be the third person ever to possibly be cured of the disease.
The first two cases were also bone marrow type transplants. That's a key thing, that folks had had a cancer that required a bone marrow transplant. And then they did the transplant with cells that were resistant to HIV infection. And then over time, the virus disappeared and did come back.
He says the woman, who was mixed race and had leukemia, was treated with a transplant method involving umbilical cord blood, which came from a partially matched donor. The two prior cases occurred in males, one white and one Latino, but the woman also received blood from a close relative to give her immune system time to adjust to the transplant.
She's 14 months or so out from her transplant, and there's no sign of HIV.
Dr. Sag says the story of the woman who was possibly cured is inspirational, but he wants to see more evidence through treatment that there could be an end to the AIDS epidemic.
Now that we know that that's proven, as we're going to find other ways, short of a bone marrow transplant, to attack those cells, develop new approaches that don't require people to go through that very dangerous procedure.
In Huntsville, Archie Snowden, News 19.
Researchers stress that the key to fighting HIV should still be focused on prevention as opposed to relying on novel and risky cures. Researchers estimate the treatment the woman receives could only benefit around 50 patients a year in the United States.